Welcome to Divas Getting Raw, episode number 16. We're your hosts. My name is Luigi PS3.
And I'm Legacy Check.
And we got a good Raw for you, so let's get right
yes,
into it.
Yes, we do. Yeah, Monday Night Raw opened up in Omaha, Nebraska. And, you know, Lauren, there were a lot of technical difficulties in the beginning of Raw. I'm like, what the heck is going on?
Someone's not paying the bills over there.
Yeah, someone's not paying the bills, or someone didn't know what the heck they were doing because they were actually cutting off R-Truth with what he was saying. Which is good. I think people like that. Who cares what R-Truth had to say? You know, for the good, 5 minutes to 10 minutes, you know, they showed R-Truth. He's, like, backstage. He's, like, throwing T-shirts of John Cena all over the place.
Yeah.
He's like,
merchandise
what
everywhere.
Is this John Cena? Like, I was, like, reading his lips because, again, you know, there was no sound. I don't know, technical difficulties. R-Truth was like, what is this, John Cena? Oh, no. He was, like, knocking down the T-shirt stand, and he was knocking down the cups on the concession stand. He was, like, just protesting. And then he comes out to the ring. Well, actually, he interacts with the crowd a little bit, calling everyone Jimmy.
Yeah.
So this is my Jimmy. And a little boy and his father is like, oh, yeah, Jimmy, what's your name? Jimmy. And then he just gets in the ring, basically mocking people.
Yeah.
Saying that it's never about me. It's never about me. It's all about John Cena. And then John Cena comes out. He had enough. John Cena comes out and then basically says to R-Truth, what in the heck is wrong with you?
I mean, this guy needs a straitjacket. He needs the doctors to come in with the white coat and wrap this guy up and take him away.
Exactly. And R-Truth is like, his response to that was, you know, it's all your fault. It's all the people's fault. And John Cena said that, John Cena said, no problem. I have no problem knocking sense into you. So then all of a sudden, the anonymous Raw general manager, you know, sends an email. And Michael Cole, he's back at ringside with the King, no more Josh Matthews. So Michael Cole reads the anonymous general manager email and says that the main event, there will be John Cena versus R-Truth. And no Jimmys.
No Jimmys allowed.
R-Truth is like, is that supposed to be a joke? You're going to get got. Whatever that means, again. So after that, we have Kofi Kingston versus Dolph Ziggler. And I thought this was a really good match.
Yeah.
I liked it. It was very entertaining. Dolph wins. And it was actually with a zigzag, and it was fair and square. Very fair and square. I was like, oh, so Kofi just lost.
Just got beat.
Yep, exactly. And then we have Alberto Del Rio comes out. And then Alberto Del Rio, he shows the clip from what happened last week with Big Show. And apparently, you know, it was an accident that Ricardo and Alberto, like, ran over
Big Show. It's an accident that the Big Show is under your front tire.
Exactly.
I don't believe it.
Yeah, and then he's saying that, you know, Big Show, you owe me money for damage to my car.
Nice.
And then he also sends his regards. Big Show, get well soon. You know, that really sucks for Big Show. I think, Big Show is, like, probably in the hospital. He wants to get back at Alberto Del Rio next week, so we'll see what happens with that. And then we have Bella Twins versus Kelly and Eve. And, you know, again, typical Divas match. Really not much to say about
it.
What can I say? Kelly and Eve won, the team of Kelly and Eve. Kelly pins pins Brie or Nikki.
One of them.
Yeah, it was a face first into a canvas. So yeah, Kelly and Eve won. Well, hooray. Whatever.
Next.
Yeah. So next up we have Michael Cole is in the ring and he addresses to the crowd saying, why did Alex Riley, remember last week?
Yes.
Why did Alex Riley basically flip out
on Miz?
And turn on the Miz, his apprentice. Oh my gosh, why did Alex Riley do that? So Alex Riley comes out and he's like, I never felt better. He never felt better in all his life. Like, he was happy that the Miz, he was happy that the Miz got beaten. And Michael Cole's like, how could you do that to your mentor? You know, he told you everything. You should apologize. He was like a brother to you. And then, basically, this is so uncalled for. Michael Cole calls Alex Riley a bastard.
Ooh.
No, that wasn't good. Alex Riley basically, like, threw down Michael Cole. But then, Miz showed up out of nowhere. Miz and Alex Riley, they began fighting, and they're fighting on the outside of the ring, and then, you know, good Alex Riley was countering, because at one point, Miz was just beating him up all, like, for so long, and then Alex Riley was just began countering him, and Miz ran into the crowd and basically ran away from Alex Riley.
Like a coward.
Exactly. While Alex Riley is just in the ring, and Miz just ran away in the crowd, disappeared. That was interesting. So, it was an alright match. I don't know. I thought it was okay. You know, at one point Mason interferes without the ref seeing, but Mason just like threw Ray into the steel post.
Yeah, always when CM Punk's people come out, he always has someone from Nexus that comes with him. And they always interfere, you know?
Exactly.
They're always a cheating like that.
So, unfortunately for Ray, CM Punk wins by that big kick to the head, which he's been doing for a few weeks to Kane and Big Show, and now it's Rey Mysterio. So, CM Punk wins by a kick to the head to Rey Mysterio. What was it? Next up, we have Karma.
Karma.
Remember what happened last week? But Lauren, she had like a nervous breakdown in front of all the divas. And I wonder what that nervous breakdown was. And she explained that she's pregnant. Oh my God.
That's a big shocker.
Karma's pregnant. And that she will basically no longer, you know, wrestle now, but she'll like wrestle a year later because the Bella Twins came out, began mocking Karma. And Karma's like, I have a new dream. And I will be seeing you a year later. Wow. Bella Twins, watch out, because karma means business, okay? Watch out, so they have a year to prepare.
Yep.
We'll see. And then after that, we have Jack Swagger versus Evan Bourne. And that's because last week, Evan Bourne, you know, like, kicked Jack Swagger after the match, a cheap kick at the end. And so they had a rematch, and Evan won.
Yeah, and it's Evan funny because Jack Swagger was like showboating a lot.
Yeah, showboating a lot.
Some top of him.
Exactly.
It was like,
yeah.
Good for Evan Bourne.
Exactly, Evan Bourne, yeah, but he won by a roll-up, good. And then backstage, Lauren, who do we see? Zack Ryder!
Broski!
You know, he's talking to John Cena, and I thought I saw a belt over his shoulder, and on the side, and on the side of the belt, I saw the Twitter logo.
Yeah, it might be his YouTube belt that he has.
YouTube belt?
And his Twitter one?
Exactly, maybe the internet. Cool. He's the internet champion.
Yes.
I think he is. Yeah, that's Zack Ryder. And then after that, we have John Cena, the main event versus R-Truth. Did not like this main event. I thought it was a waste of time. Was it? R-Truth basically had John Cena chase after him.
Yeah, to the little Jimmies.
Yeah, to the little Jimmies. Like, they went over the barricade, and with a cheap win, R-Truth won by a count out. Yeah, by a count out, because John Cena got hit outside the barricade by R-Truth, and R-Truth just ran back in the ring and won. And it sucks, because and then after the win, R-Truth went back into the people, went back into the stands where the people were sitting, and then you see the little Jimmy, the little boy that he was interacting with in the beginning of Raw, and he like grabbed his cup of soda and like threw his drink
in the father's face,
and then John Cena, and then R-Truth like ran away after he did that, and then John Cena, you know, he went over to the father and son.
Yeah,
it was like, are you okay? Are you okay? Here's my armband. And it ended with that, with John Cena, you know, saving the day.
John Cena saving the day.
But, yeah, and that was just about it for the ending of Raw. I know. I don't know.
And then they were also plugging Capital Punishment that'll be coming up soon. So.
Capital Punishment in Washington, D.C. Yes. Yeah, Barack Obama is getting ready for it. Barack Obama is getting ready for Capital Punishment.
He
what
is.
Can we say?
I wonder what his special move would be. Write it down in the description below.
Definitely.
What Barack Obama's special move would be in the WWE.
That's hard. Yeah, definitely.
Be clever with it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it?
That's it.
Do we have some shout-outs?
Not that I know of.
I'm going to give a shout-out to my brother Michael.
Hi, Mike.
Thank you, Michael, for getting me addicted to Plants vs. Zombies.
Zombies.
And that's it. And
that's
to everyone watching. So
thank you very
hope
much.
Hope you enjoyed this episode.
Bye, guys.
Bye.